Hi, I'm Dr. John Mamarian, and I'm from the Houston Methodist Heart and Vascular Center in Houston, Texas. And today I talked about an important topic in cardiac imaging, particularly with myocardial perfusion imaging, that of performing stress-only imaging. And the concept behind this is that typically we do stress or rest imaging first, followed by rest or stress imaging as a two-part study. But that can lead to a lot of unnecessary radiation exposure in patients. So many years ago, we started the idea of maybe just doing stress first, and if the stress first study was normal, then not having to go on and doing a rest study. And so there was considerable concern about the safety of this approach, because without the rest study for comparing the stress study, you might miss certain things. But there have now been two major publications, one from our own center in 17,000 patients, and one from another site, Dr. Henslova's site at Mount Sinai, in 5,000 patients, showing that stress-only imaging, where you look at the stress image, determine it's normal, and do not bring the patient back for rest imaging, has the same prognostic value in terms of a normal study as a normal stress-rest or rest-stress study. And so there is no concern in this regard about bringing patients back for a second set of images in terms of causing harm to the patient. The benefits are that it adds a lot of convenience for the patient in terms of not having to wait several more hours to get a rest or stress study. It also reduces the need for technetium and therefore cost. And it also reduces radiation exposure over 50 to 60%. So that on a normal stress-only study, you might be able to give the patient only 5 millisieverts of radiation as compared to 10 to 15 millisieverts of radiation on a normal stress-rest protocol. The other important issue is that it can be applied to many different types of patients, both in the emergency department setting, large patients with the use of attenuation correction. And now there are some very new cameras that use CZT technology where you can actually image patients within 2 to 3 minutes, or you can reduce the dose by 50% and double the imaging time. So there are a lot of new nuances in terms of how we can image patients and ultimately get down to administering no more than 1 to 2 millisieverts of radiation to our patients who would otherwise come back and have much higher doses if they had conventional imaging.